Hello everyone, in this demo we will see delegates. So what are delegates? Delegates are nothing but pointers to the function. So we have been hearing this term pointers to the function. So now we will see what do you mean by a pointer to the function or a pointer to the method. Now say I have a method, a static. See why? Because I am writing the method in the same class program. So I'll just say use static method, static void show, and it takes a parameter, say string and name. Now here I'll say console.writeline show hello plus that name, whatever I have passed. So this is my simple method. Now if I want to invoke that method from my main method, why? Because my main method is static, so from static members can access only static members. So my main method is static, so I want to access this show method, so that's why I have kept the show method as static. Now I'll just call that method, I'll say show, and here I'll be passing a name. I'll be passing say Manzoor. So this is my simple program, simple method calling program. Put a breakpoint, say F5. So whenever my control reaches the show method, it will jump to the show method and it will take Manzoor as the parameter and it will display that on the output screen. So this is my simple show method calling. Now this kind of binding is called as static binding. That means the code for this method is generated at compile time itself. Why? Because I have show method, I am calling it directly. Now I'll go in another way. Now I'll call the same method but in different way using delegates concept. I'll call the same method show using delegate concept. Now I'll be declaring a delegate, delegate void. I'll name the delegate as test and the parameter is string name. Now I'll be declaring a delegate. My delegate is nothing but function prototype or method prototype or method signature. So I am declaring a delegate or I am declaring a method signature which does not return anything, so it's void and it takes a single parameter. It takes a single parameter. Using this delegate I can work with all the methods whose return type is void and the parameter is a string. Like I have show method whose return type is void and parameter is one, that is a string. Now I can have one more method. I'll just copy this. Say I have one more method, that method is display. And here its implementation is display hello. Hello and the name. Now both of these methods, even though they are different methods, this is show method, this is display method, but both of them have the same return type and same parameter. So both of these methods can be invoked with the help of this delegate. Now how to invoke that or how to call that method, we will see. Now this is my delegate. Now I'll be creating an object of this delegate, test. How? In the same way as we were creating the object of a class. I'll say test t equals to new test. Now the constructor that I need to pass whenever I create the object, this is my constructor. The parameter that I need to pass, that means I need to initialize this t. That means I'll say that this t will be referring to what method? Is it show or display? I'll just say show. It will be referring to show. Now if I want to invoke the method show, now I won't be calling the method directly. I'll be calling it with the help of the reference t dot invoke. I'll pass the parameter. Now you see that the same thing that we did it statically, now we are making it dynamically. Or it was compile time binding, this is runtime binding. Why? Because I am using new keyword to allocate the memory. Now I'll just put a breakpoint. I'll say F5. Now I'll say F11. Object gets created. Now it is going to invoke the show method. See that it has invoked the show method. It comes back. Now, what I can do, instead of invoking the show method using t dot invoke, I can directly say t of. That means by default, it is going to work in this sense. But from here onwards, I'll not use invoke method. I'll just directly say t of. That means I'm calling. Now t is acting like show method. So show of Manzoor. Now if I press F5, it is going to display me the same result. Show hello Manzoor. Now this is fine. It is not a big deal. The same thing that we did with this. I'm doing the same thing with the help of some, you know, object of delegate and calling the method or invoking the method. Now what is the another thing that I can do? Now I can say that t equals to new test of display. Now my t pointer or my t, now it will be referring to display method. Now if I say t of Manzoor, this time it will be calling the display method. So first it was pointing to show, it was showing show method. Now it is pointing to display, so it will show display method, or it is going to execute display method. So I am getting some runtime polymorphism concept over here. That means I can make t an object of any method at runtime, and I'll call t dot Manzoor so that it is going to execute that method at runtime. That means the code for this method will be, or code for this line will be generating at runtime. So anyway, hope you are not getting confused. So this is a simple way of using delegates. Now even till here it's fine. Now let us see one more advantage of this. Now I'll just comment out this thing. So t, earlier it was referring to show method. Now I made it refer to display method. So it is going to work with display method. That's fine. That means earlier it was referring to show method. Now I have changed its reference to display method. Now what I can do here, instead of t equals to test of display, instead of changing the reference from show to display, I can add it. I'll say plus equal to. That means it was referring to show. Now I have added one more reference to the same. Now t will be referring to both show as well as display. Now you see the magic. If I say t of Manzoor, what is my intention, or what is it I'll be expecting? What is it I'll be expecting? I'll be expecting it to execute display method. But I have used plus equal to symbol. That means now it is referring to show as well as display. So once I call this t of Manzoor, it is going to execute show first, then display next. So this is the magic of your delegates. Now if I do the same, if I add one more reference to the same display, it is going to execute show once and display twice. This is called as, see, one reference executing multiple things. One reference executing multiple things or multiple methods. With a single line of code, I am executing multiple methods. This is called as multicasting, multicast delegates. I can multicast the delegate with the help of plus equal to symbol. So this concept is called as multicasting. Now as I can add a reference, in the same way I can remove the reference. So now I'll say t minus equal to new test of display. Now what is that it will do? It has added display and it has removed display. So it is going to execute show and display once. both the thing. So this concept is called as multicasting. Hope you might have understood. Single cast delegates, if I comment this, this is single cast, it is going to execute only Manzoor. If I uncomment this, this is multicast. Multicast delegates, single casting and multicast. So a delegate is nothing but it is a reference to a method, and I can refer to the method whose signature or you know return type and parameters matches with the delegate. See, the return type is void, void, parameter is string, string. So I can use it here. So this is the concept of delegates. Thank you very much.